At home or your office, thank you so much for joining us. My name is Emily Smith. I'm the Director of External Relations at the Community Foundation. And if this is your first time at the Community Foundation, I know a lot of you have worked with us before. We are also a nonprofit organization. And what we do is we have donors that start charitable funds here at the foundation, and that they can then use those funds to grant out to other nonprofits. And we also have a competitive grant application process with our unrestricted funds, which I believe a lot of you guys participated. So thank you so much for being here at the Community Foundation, and we're going to talk about Give for Good, which is one of our initiatives, which was started back in 2014 by my predecessor, Jennifer Stedman, and the Community Foundation. A lot of you probably remember Jennifer, so if you're wondering why I'm here and who I am, I'm the new Jennifer. Since then, we have raised over $6.3 million for nonprofits in our community. So that is directly back to nonprofits in unrestricted funds. So those are in the past 4 years that we and you guys have raised that amount of money. So we're really excited to get started this year. This is my favorite initiative to work on, and I'm excited that 2018 is going to be hopefully the biggest year yet. But let's go ahead and just start with an overview of what exactly. They were just in here playing with this. Of course, the smart board wasn't working earlier, so now, of course, the clicker isn't working. Well, let's hope that's not it. Okay. draw mode. Trust me, you don't want to see me draw anything on screen. I'm a terrible artist. Okay, so what is Give for Good? Give for Good is a 24-hour online giving challenge hosted by the Community Foundation where nonprofits register and raise unrestricted funds during that day. So it brings donors and nonprofits together in a really unique way. It's all online, and it's up to us and you to market it and try to raise as many unrestricted funds as we can for your organization. So a little bit more about that. Like I said, it's a 24-hour online giving challenge. It is only online, so we cannot accept checks or cash that day. But it's a great way to meet new donors, particularly a younger market, if you're interested in that. So you can throw those new donors that maybe have not given to your organization before, or any organization before, and we can capture that new portion of the market. It's for North Louisiana nonprofits, so people doing services in North Louisiana in our 14 parish area, and I'll go over a little bit more about that in a minute. It's for unrestricted funds. You can spend them on whatever you want as long as you're spending them in our 14 parish area. And last year, over $1.6 million was raised for area nonprofits. And when is it? May 1st, 2018. It's always on the first Tuesday of May. And so it'll be May 1st this year, coming up quickly. And why would you participate, or why would your organization participate in Give for Good? But the real question here is, why wouldn't you participate in Give for Good? It creates a collective impact because all of our nonprofits, we are stronger together than we are one-on-one. So think about all of the philanthropists, all of the donors in our community coming together on one day to give to all of our nonprofit organizations that are registered. So by getting together, making that collective impact, we can grow more funds for your organization, for all of the other organizations, and more impact on our community. But just a few bulleted reasons of why participate. It creates a seamless experience for your donors. It's really easy to use. If your donors can shop online or use a Facebook page, they can participate in Give for Good. Also, we have the Lanyap Fund, which is an opportunity for you to earn bonus funds for your organization. I'll get more to that in a second. And then also prizes, because we love prizes. And that's also extra dollars for your organization. So not only do you raise funds from your donors, we are going to give you a little bit of matching funds, and I'll go over that in a second. So for the donor experience, like I said, it's as easy as online shopping. And donors can shop from multiple organizations in one place. So a donor can go online, say, oh, I like this organization, this one, as many as they would like. They can donate anywhere from $10, the sky's the limit, we don't have a maximum limit on donations, and they can add all of those organizations to their cart, click, and check out with one easy payment. So it's really easy to use. Also, the donor will receive an immediate receipt from us and that tax deductible letter, the gift acknowledgement, so you don't have to worry about any of that. So not only is it easy on the donors, it's easy as you got for you guys as well, because if you don't have a way to take online payments, which I know is really hard, you gotta set up the PayPal, can be really complex. So if you don't do that, this is a way to take online payments through the year. So you can do a big donation push on this day. And then like I said, the collective impact. So not only are more people participating better for us because all of the nonprofits and the community directly benefit from the collective impact, but also the donors do as well. So if you think about those donors that have never donated to an organization before or don't consider themselves philanthropists, they need to be a philanthropist of any size on that day. So they may think, what would this organization want to do with my $10 or my $20? But on this day, they can be a part of a larger pool and really see the impact that they're making on the community. So our average donation each year is $25, which is a really great thing to think about because it's not just those giant donors that, as nonprofit organizations, we're always going after those big sponsorships, big memberships, but it's the people that are giving as much as they can to make a huge impact on that day. The Lanyap Fund is next, which I know is everybody's favorite part about Give for Good, is those matching funds, those multiplying dollars to get you more funds for your organization. So the way that the Lanyap Fund works is that the Community Foundation raises money to go into this bonus pool of funds. So our sponsors, we get grants, and the Lanyap Fund usually ends up being between $200,000 and $250,000. Last year was $230,000. And then based on the percentage that you receive during Give for Good, we divide those funds up amongst you guys. So not only, like I said earlier, are you getting your funds, we are giving you back some of the extra for participating in Give for Good. This is not a dollar-for-dollar match, so I really want to go over that really quickly because the Lagniappe Fund can be difficult to understand, and we always get a lot of questions about this part. So the Lagniappe Fund is this bonus pool, and it is divvied out as a percentage of what you raised during Give for Good. So say that of the $1.6 million raised last year, your organization captured 1% of that. So you would receive 1% of the Lagniappe Fund. There are a couple of stipulations. Your organization must raise at least $500 to be able to get a portion of the Lagniappe Fund. So as long as the funds raised are over $500, you're going to get a percentage of the Lagniappe Fund. Also, any donation over $10,000, only $10,000 of it goes to the Lagniappe Fund. So if you got mega lucky on Give for Good Day and somebody wanted to give you $50,000, only $10,000 of that would count toward your Give for Good percentage, so that we can kind of prevent people from gaming the system and kind of playing it that way. So we like to keep things fair around here because everybody benefits in Give for Good. And then it's distributed to nonprofits. Yep, like I just said, based on a percentage. I'm used to having the presentation right next to me, so I apologize for turning around and talking all the time. Does anybody have any questions about the Lagniappe Fund? No? Okay, prizes, another really exciting part. So about $25,000 are available in prizes through Give for Good. We have a bunch of different variety of prizes, and your organizations will be divided up into small and large based on your operating budget. So first of all, we have the pre-event prizes, like we'll have a little Facebook contest. These are usually based on social media performance, who's gearing up and doing their marketing ahead of time for Give for Good. And prizes range in between $500 and $2,000. So these are a lot of extra funds that you can earn for your organization. We also have participation prizes given every hour to small and large organizations. So this is most donors for X hour to small organization, $1,000, large organization, $1,000. So that's a really fun way to get creative with how you're doing your marketing. So not many people are probably up at 3 a.m., 4 a.m. So you want to say, okay, all of the donors, let's get together. We're all going to donate at 3 a.m. And then that way, you can capture the 3 a.m. prize of most donors. It gets really competitive out there. I love seeing the different marketing schemes that y'all come up with. We also have golden tickets, which are randomly drawn every hour, so it's no competition between there, just random. And then the post-event prizes for large and small organizations, most donors first, second, and third place. And then also we have a most improved and notable newcomers as well. So based on your performance, you can also earn prizes after Good for Good. And all of that will be computed in with your Lagniappe Fund, and you'll receive a check from us sometime in June, all of that totaled up. All right, so how does it work? Does anybody have any questions so far? This is the easy part. How does it work? Some eligibility requirements, a main overview. You have to be a 501c3 public charity. So we go through, we check your GuideStar account, make sure that you're in good standing with the IRS, and then you'll also give us a Secretary of State certificate of good standing and the nonprofit agreement, so that we're all on the same page that you are a nonprofit and available to accept these funds. You also have to be located in and serving our 14 parish area. I'm not gonna read them all, but it is on our website if you'd like to look at that. But donors don't have to be from this area. So that's the great thing about it. We have donors from, I believe, 48 different states last year. So we get to recruit people from across the country and the world even to come and give through Give for Good. So although the funds have to be spent here in the North Louisiana community, the funds don't have to come from here, which is a really exciting part of it. The funds that you raise have to be used in this area. And then you get one profile per tax ID number. And this can get, really iffy. I know a lot of nonprofits have a lot of great programs that they want to highlight, but you get one profile. So we try to encourage you to not highlight one program at a time and really raise those unrestricted funds for your organization, because this is your chance to raise unrestricted funds. The grants, you may have to use them for a particular need. Here, just for your organization. So that means that I'm going to pick on the prizes because Kitty's here and I know she won't get mad at me. So that means that the film prize can't register the startup prize, the film prize, the food prize, the XYZ prize, however many they have. They can only fundraise for that. Same with like Volunteers of America, they can register one program. So only one profile per tax ID number. GiverGood is lots of fun. We don't have a lot of creative restrictions on what you can do. A lot of people come up with some really great campaigns out there, but we do have a few rules that everyone must follow. The number one rule, let me put on my serious face. The number one rule that everyone must follow is that donors cannot receive any benefits from donating to GiverGood. This means no memberships, no sponsorships, no tickets, no t-shirts, no anything of that kind. And let me explain to you why that is. So whenever somebody donates to GiverGood, we immediately send them that gift acknowledgement letter and their receipt. So say that somebody gives $500 to your organization, and then you give them $200 worth of tickets. Well, really, that's only $300 worth of tax-deductible donations, but we already sent them the letter for $500. So if they are donating through GiverGood, which is through the Community Foundation, they cannot receive any material benefits for that. And if you have any questions or doubts or anything, please call us, because we don't mind, you know, helping you work through those issues or anything like that. But that is a hard and fast rule. If we find out that your organization is not complying with these rules, you may be ineligible to participate next year, or you may have your Lagniappe fund taken back from you or not issued to you, or you may not receive the Lagniappe fund next year. So we take this very seriously. Again, if you have any questions or doubts, don't hesitate to ask us. We don't want anybody to get in trouble for this. Also, if you're hosting a party or an event, we ask that you provide insurance to us and also add us as an additional insurer. That protects you, protects us, everybody wins. And then you also have to adhere to all due dates, deadlines, as set forth by the Community Foundation, which I will communicate to you via email and the GiverGood website to your profile. Does anybody have any questions so far? How it works or anything like that? No? Okay, so the process is, your organization registers for GiverGood, we approve it, woo, you're good to go, you build an outstanding profile, and then you recruit donors on GiverGood Day and convince them why they should be giving to your organization. So we want to make those profiles really attractive, really tell what you're doing, what the great things that you're doing in the community are, so that they say, wow, they're doing a really great job, I would love to give them my money. So we help with the marketing, because we want GiverGood to succeed. We want all of you guys to succeed, and ultimately the community will benefit from that. But you also have to do your part as well with telling people, hey, you need to go give through our GiverGood campaign. You need to help the community, because it's a great event. So again, the harder we work together, the more we all benefit. Then on the day, donors will shop and give as much as they like or as much as they can, and then you receive your funds from us. So when anybody donates through GiverGood, they are donating to us. We put them into your little pools, and then we write in one check to you. You'll be able to see all of the individual donations so that you can thank your donors and things like that, but you will receive one check from the Community Foundation approximately late June, mid to late June. A little bit of information for your donors. We've already gone over some of this, but just to reiterate, they're gonna go for GiverGood, to get the GiverGood website, givergoodnla.org. They're gonna shop for their favorite organizations and causes so they can search by zip code, see what people are doing in their community. They can search for you by name. They can search for you by sector, like education or human services. They'll shop around, find all the things they wanna give to, and they'll add them all to their carts with the different donation amounts that they would like to give. Then they check out. One easy process, woohoo, we're good to go. And then they will immediately receive that receipt and a tax deductible letter by email from us. So it's all a really simple process, just like online shopping. And then all donations, yes, are tax deductible. We'll issue the gift acknowledgement receipt, so you don't have to do that. Please don't do that twice. Charges will be from the Community Foundation on their credit card. So if you have anybody calling you or asking, what is this? Or my credit card says the money didn't go to you. It comes to us, and then we write you one check for all of your donations again. You will receive a list of donors and their contact information so that you can thank them. We hope you thank them. And then you will also receive one check from us in June. Fees. This is great information to know for your donors in case they ask about it. There's an approximate 4.9% fee assessed on all transactions through Gift for Good. And donors can either choose to pay the fee themselves, which a lot of people do, or they can pass the fees on to your organization. So 2.8% of the fees goes to CivicCorps, which is our online hosting platform. And then 2.1% plus 30 cents is the standard credit card processing fee, so charged to the credit card processing. And then no fees will go to the Community Foundation. So we don't receive any benefits from hosting Gift for Good other than the warm sensation that we got to help the community and work with all of you guys. But no fees come to the Community Foundation. We give all of those monies back out to you. And then also no fees are charged on Laying Out Fund or prize dollars. So the fees go on to the donations from the donors. Anything you receive from the Lanyard Fund or from the prize is just added on top of that, minus no fees, and then issued to you in one check. Does anybody have any questions about any of that so far? Awesome. You guys are doing so great. No one has any questions? All right, so step one is registration. There are two phases to the Give for Good application. Step one, step two. Super easy to remember. And step one is just applying, saying, yes, I want to participate, and then we'll just double check and make sure that you are a 501c3 public charity and that you're in good standing. So the first part's really simple. You go to giveforgoodnla.org. If you have not already bookmarked this page, make sure that you do that because you're going to be spending a lot of time there. It always stays up on my desktop. And then you go here to the Give for Good homepage. Amazing. You go to the homepage. It's going to look like this, pretty much until the end of the registration process, and then it's going to flip to the donor-friendly side. So right now it's nonprofit-friendly for registration. Then it'll switch to donor-friendly, and you'll basically be using the back end of your profile. So when you want to register, you're going to hit here, register, in the upper right-hand corner in the blue. This is if you are a new organization or you did not participate in Give for Good in 2017. So if you participated last year, don't pay attention. Don't hit this button. We'll go over yours in just a second. So if you're new to Give for Good, hit the blue button, and it will take you to a registration page. Really basic information, your name, your contact info, a little bit about your organization, not too in-depth yet, but the things that you have to have handy, the two things that maybe aren't off the top of your head, are the tax ID number. So you can find that on your IRS documents. You have to have the tax ID number to register for Give for Good. And then also your link URL. Link URL. So what is link? That's a great question, and we get this one a lot. So Susan Campbell, who is kind of our in charge of link for the Community Foundation, is going to come up and explain for just a couple of minutes what link is and why we use it in our Give for Good registration. Yay, Susan!
Yay! I'm so excited to see so many familiar faces here for Give for Good 2018. I'm even more excited that I'm not in charge of Give for Good. So, yay! But what I can tell you still about is LINC, the Louisiana Initiative for Nonprofit and Community Collaboration. As most of you are aware, it's an online website that has all the nonprofits and community initiatives in Northwest Louisiana. I also try to put up information for nonprofits, have some new grant information I'll be putting up at the end of the week, so make sure you take a look at that. But what we were talking about today is LINC, and I realized I missed my cue. There we go. Oh. Okay. So you go to www.linc.us. This is what you will see. That is going to be changing in the next month. I know I've mentioned it before at meetings. I'm very excited about when we go to the next LINC 2.0 that you'll be able to use it from your phone. For now, we still have this. If you have not registered as a user for LINC, please remember to register as yourself using your own personal, your professional email address, but not just your organization's address, because someone will inevitably move, they'll change jobs, and you won't have the passwords, and you will call. So just click here to register now, and that will register you on the website. And we'll show you in a little bit what that application looks like. If you are wondering if your link profile for your nonprofit is up to date, all you have to do is put the name of your organization in here, and you click that button, and it will search for your nonprofit. So what we want to make sure that everyone has done is that it is up to date, that your address is up to date, your phone number. Because if people are looking to Give for Good and they want more information, what does your nonprofit do? What are the other things? They can click on your link URL. They'll come here. They'll be able to see more of all of the programs in detail, as well as your Form 990. So they're going to get detailed information about your program. We want to make sure it's up to date, that it's current, that when you read this description, that it makes sense to you and will make sense to someone that has not been introduced to your program before. Let's see. So when it says on the organization, on the Give for Good application, that you will need to copy your URL and paste it into the Give for Good application, this is the URL. If you just hover over it, it'll click on it. It will, you'll see it'll be highlighted. Just do a right click, copy, and put it on your Give for Good application. See if people are still looking. This is it. This is the URL. You'll see at the end it has your specific number. Copy the entire address, then, not just the last digits of that number. Now, when you do click register now, this is what it will look like. It's very simple. Like she said, if you've done any online shopping, if you bought, I always say if you bought a book off Amazon, which it always shows my age when I say that, then you're just going to fill out your information, last name, first name, your professional email address. You're going to have to come up with a username. It actually is pretty easy just to use your email address. That's what I recommend. And your password. Make sure you look here to see the specifics of what type of password you will need. And then you will click Find My Organization. For me, I would look for the Community Foundation. I would attach myself to that organization. And then whenever I pull up my user ID, if I need to make any changes to my organization's profile, then it will come up and let me do that. Once you make those changes, then those changes will be submitted to me, and I will review them and approve them. Just as a safeguard to make sure that everything you're putting up is accurate and correct, and also that we don't have other people trying to change your information. Are there any questions about Link? Great, I'll turn it back to Emily. She's doing a great job, and we're so excited. I'm so excited she's here.
Thank you. All right, thank you, Susan. So yeah, we're gonna register for Link. You're gonna copy that URL, put it into your Give for Good profile, and that way donors and community members can find you all year long, not just during Give for Good. So once you have that in there, you just hit submit, and what happens next is that we receive your application. We do our due diligence in making sure that you are a 501c3 public charity. If there's anything fishy or anything like that, don't worry. I'll call you if I can't find you, and we will work it out, because a lot of times, sometimes, you know, you just typed in your information wrong and I can't find you on GuideStar. There aren't really a whole lot of problems that we can't fix or help you with. So we'll approve you, and then you'll receive an email with instructions on setting up your profile. Click the link. You'll create your profile. You can also add users after that point so that you and your other staff members and volunteers can begin filling out the profile and telling everybody in the world why your organization and your programs are so fantastic. You're always going to log in through giveforgoodnla.org to make updates. So again, make sure that you bookmark that page, commit it to your memory, dream about it, everything until May 1st. So, if you participated in 2017, you can now open your eyes and your ears, because this pertains to you. So, again, back to the homepage. Instead of clicking the blue register button, which will create a duplicate account for your organization, no bueno, we're gonna hit the green login button at the top. When you hit it, it'll say donor or nonprofit. You'll select nonprofit. You'll put in your information from last year. If you can't remember what that is, just hit forgot password. It'll help you reset that. And if you really can't figure it out, just call me or email me and we can get it fixed that way. But you're gonna log into Give for Good just like you did last year when you were making all of these updates. And then when you log in, you will see your profile and it'll look like this. We're picking on Common Ground today because theirs is already up and approved and everything. So you'll see, this is your back end. You can make changes to all of your profile and everything. You can add users, and we'll talk all about all of this stuff later. But the main thing is that you hit submit for approval by January 19th. So the two things that you have to do by January 19th are go and update your legal name. That's for transparency for our donors. We want them to make sure they know exactly who they're donating to. So your organization name will be what pops up really big and what's searchable on Give for Good. And then your legal name is going to be on your IRS documents, so you want to make sure that those match. For example, Robinson Film Center is actually Red River Film Society doing business as Robinson Film Center. Fun fact, a lot of people don't know that. So we want to make sure the legal name is exactly what's on your documents. So that's really important if you have a DBA, or if you are using one of your programs, or if you've changed your name, anything like that. And then right here where they've already done this, but their profile status right here, yours will look like this if you've not completed your registration yet. It'll say profile status and then submit for approval. You have to click that button, and I'm going to do a little fancy little thing. Click the button before January 19th to be submitted. Here's where it gets a little bit tricky. So if you go back and you wanted to edit your information down here, edit. When you go to save your information, that button also says submit. It just says submit. So you'll submit that, and that saves your information. But you have to go back to this page and hit submit for approval in order to actually put your registration in. And that way, it triggers me and says, hey, these people registered, rather than just saving your information from last year. Okay, does anybody have any questions about registration step one? All right, so step number two is one of the more important pieces of it. It's building your profile. Again, telling the world why you are the organization that they want to give money to. And so there are a lot of different pieces. It's very versatile, and you can tell your stories and tell about your brand in a lot of different ways. Like I said, this is going to be your back end and what it looks like. So when you log in, you can add users over here. You can add as many as you like, so they all have their own login and password and everything like that. You can see who's doing the updating, so that way you can have staff members and volunteers helping you out. This isn't a one-man show. Sometimes you got to get help. Give for Good takes a lot of people. Takes a lot of teamwork to get it done. So you can add users to edit your basic information. You just hit the edit button right here, and then you can edit all of your information. Hit save/submit. And then we also have a lot of different features aside from your basic information. So overview is where the basics were. You want to make sure you have your mission statement on there and fill out as much information about your organization as you can, because when those donors are shopping, they get to read all of that information aside from your really personal stuff like your tax ID number. All of that is hidden, but all of your public information, you want to make sure that it looks good. So check it, have someone else check it, make sure that you don't have typos, because you really want to make sure that you're presenting yourself well to the donors and giving them information about why your organization is doing great things and what you're doing in the community. So after overview comes donation information. So this is where, if you click on that button, you will see a list of all of the people who donated to you during Give for Good Day. You'll see their contact information so that you can send them a thank you note, call them up and say hey. Some people give shout outs on social media. It all depends on what you want to do for your organization, but you'll be able to see that info there. You'll also be able to set donation levels. This was new with CiviCorps last year. So you can set it as $20 is one backpack to a child, or $100 is, you know, 1 week of meals for a family. So that way, when the donor goes to your page, they don't just have to see how much would you like to input. They can see things like that and say, like, I want to buy a backpack of school supplies. I want to buy a week's worth of food. So you can set those for yourself in your different donation levels. Kind of a little way to market yourself and your programs. After donation levels, we have events. If you would like to host events on Give for a Good Day, you can put that there. You can also host different events throughout the year. You can put it all on there so that donors can see what you're doing. Multimedia is photos and videos. And then campaigns is something that we'll be going over in late March, early April when the campaigns open. So that's part of the marketing training. But basically, as a campaign is where a donor can register and raise funds for your organization in their name. but we'll go over more of that later. And then documents is the really important section for that February 16th step 2 deadline. This is where you have to go and you have to upload a Secretary of State certificate of good standing, and you also have to upload the 2018 nonprofit agreement. So if we were to go back to here, there would be an orange bar right above here with some different administrative things, and one of them would say resources. If you click on resources, it has instructions on how to find your Secretary of State certificate of good standing and upload it, and then it also has the nonprofit agreement. I'll also be posting information from this training, other trainings, everything you need to know, images, cover photos, profile photos, everything that we have, I'll be adding to the resources section as we go. So it's a great thing to always keep checking, see what's new there, and then also upload them to the documents section by February 16th is when all of those documents are due. Okay, does anybody have any questions about phase two or building your profile? Y'all are making this too easy on me. Y'all are good. Okay, so important dates. Make sure that you write these down, put them on a sticky note, hang it up on your wall. Don't miss any of these. January 19th, step one closes. That's when you have to have that legal name updated and hit submit for approval, or if you're a new organization, fill out the registration form completely for the first time. February 16th is when step two closes. So what's due on February 16th? Those two documents, Secretary of State Certificate of Good Standing and the nonprofit agreements, just stating that you agree to our rules and our guidelines and your eligibility criteria. So then we have a little while until April 2nd is when campaigns open. And this is when the Give for Good marketing goes haywire. This is when we really get into the point of collecting those donors and recruiting people to donate to you for Give for Good Day. That's April 2nd. April 13th, your organization profiles are frozen. So even though everybody has to be in and approved, listed publicly by February 16th, you have until April 13th to keep making changes to your information, to your profiles, building those profiles, adding videos and photos, making it really fun and interactive, and then also your event insurance is due. So April 13th, plan your event by then. If you're gonna have an event, it's not mandatory, not required, but if you are, you have to have the event insurance list us as an additional insured and get it to us by April 13th. April 17th, scheduling gifts opens. This is when donors can go into the website and schedule their gift ahead of time. Maybe they're going on vacation on Gift for Good Day, and you can say, that's all right. You can schedule it ahead of time. April 27th is the last day to create a campaign because the campaigns have to be approved through us. And again, we'll go over campaigns and marketing strategy and everything in that March training. And then May 1st is Gift for Good Day. Yay! And then that's when everything's going to go crazy. We're going to do so much for the community. We're going to raise tons of unrestricted dollars, and we're all going to have a really great time. So connect with us online. Again, the website is giftforgoodnla.org. If you need to email me, email giftforgood@cfnla.org. cfnla.org is the Community Foundation website if you ever want to know any more information about us. We're also at facebook.com/thecommunityfoundation and then @confoundnla on Twitter. So lots of different ways to connect with us and reach us through those avenues. So, does anybody have any questions?
Will donors from donor advised funds be able to make transfers into this year?
Yes, they will. So, if anybody's listening at home, she asked if people that have donor advised funds here at the Community Foundation will be able to make donations to Give for Good. Yes, we will open that process up in March, April-ish, and they will be able to designate funds and grants so that they appear during Give for Good. Anybody else?
There's one on the live stream. The question is, website says link is only for Bossier Parish, Caddo Parish, DeSoto Parish, Natchitoches Parish, and Webster Parish. Are the other parishes eligible?
That is a great question. Susan, you want to chime in?
Yes, we've started adding the parishes going east on I-20. So the other parishes,
Susan's coming so you can see her.
Yes, we are adding the other parishes. Please register for link, and what I can do is easily override the system. So you, I would also encourage you, before you click the Add a New Organization button. Search to see if your organization has already been added.
All right. Great. Anything else? Christy.
I'm a donor.
Yes, so Christy asked about the fees, and do the donors know what the fees are? Is that explained on the website? And the answer is yes. So when they go through the whole checkout process, it will say, these fees are applied to this donation. Would you like to cover them, or would you like to pass them on? And then if they choose to cover them, it will give them a new total of how much they owe, and then they'll submit from there.
Donors still have the option to be anonymous, correct?
Yes. So the donors, that's a great question. So on that donation information, on the back end of your profile, if donors have chosen to remain anonymous, which they can do, then you won't know who that is. You'll see that you got a donation, but you won't see any contact information or a name or anything like that.
We got a couple more questions on the live stream.
Yeah.
What are the benefits of having a Give for Good event? Do organizations get better results with an event?
Oh, that is a really great question. I don't know any statistics on exactly what performs better during Give for Good or not, but I will definitely say that if you are hosting an event, you definitely want to think out how much are you anticipating on getting during Give for Good, and will hosting a benefit, an event, be equal, will that be equivalent to what you're going to raise during Give for Good? So you want to, although we can't guarantee how much you're going to make during Give for Good, if you host an event, we don't want you to host an extravagant event and then have that cost more than you got. So I think really think about what the costs of your event are going to be, what the size of your event is going to be, and then see how much you anticipate getting during Give for Good and kind of weighing that out. And events can be small or large. You could rent out a giant venue and host a party and invite all the people to come and learn about your organization. Or you can, you know, host some sort of online event or just stop by our office and, you know, learn more about us and chat with us. So it doesn't have to be extravagant, but I would definitely say events are a good way to market your organization and get people involved, but definitely weigh the cost-benefit analysis. And there was another question?
Yes. Is the Lanyap Fund over and above the $25,000 in prizes, or are they one in the same?
The $25,000 comes out of the Lanyap Fund. So that's a great question. Anything else? Anybody have other questions? All right. Well, thank you guys so much for coming. If you have any questions, I'll be around to answer them, and you can always call me or email me. Anybody on our staff would be happy to help you. Thanks again, and we'll see y'all soon.